Hello friends, myself S.M.Math, assistant professor from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur, mechanical department. Today I am going to explain the general introductions of the power transmission system. For this, the learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of this session, the student will able to describe the construction and working of the power transmission system, like belts, ropes, chains, gears. So these are the different type of what you call power transmission systems are there. So these are the contents, power transmission systems, that is belt and ropes, the first one, second one is a chains one, third one is a gear one. In the first one, when you have to select the any type of power transmission system, we have to know what are the different media you can use it. For that, you can, three type of varieties are to be there, regularly used, that is a belts and ropes, then chains are there, gears are there. In the gears, different type of the gears and gear trains are to be used here. The first of all, the belts and ropes are there. The motion is transmitted between the input shaft and the output shaft, the driver and the follower, that is due to the friction between the belt and the pulley surfaces. The pulleys are to be mounted on the driver and the driven or follower shafts are there. And the frictional resistance between these pulleys and the belts, the reason for the power transmission systems. Basically, there are two types of belts are there, flat belt, V belt, and sometimes circular type, that is cord type belts are to be used for the power transmission system. So these are the some diagrams I am showing here. It is a flat belt type. It is a belt and this section one, that is a pulley one. It is a V belt type. When you have to go for the V belt type, the angle, this angle is to be minimum, maximum 30 degrees to be there, and this is a rope type, that is a circular, just I am explaining one. Now you go for a next one, chains. So when you have to go for a belt drive is not a positive drive because there is a slippages to be there and the creep is to be there. So chain drive is a positive drive. Chain is to be used for transmission larger center distance between the two shafts. That is the distance between the input shafts and the output shaft is a more one. You can use the chain and positive power transmission system is to be there. And these are made of some linkages are there, metal linkages to be there, heavier metal linkages to be there with respect to the belt one. When you have to go for the belt material, belt is a leather is there, cotton is there, metal threads are there, plastic threads are there. And when the friction between the belt and the pulley is to be, motion is to be transmitted, heat is to be produced. And when the heat is to be produced, elongation is to be there, expansion is to be there of that belt material, and due to which the length of the belt is slightly increased. When the length of the belt is slightly increases, slippages are to be there. So that is not happened in the chain drive. Because in the chain drive, instead of chain, some linkages of the metals are to be used. For that, the main only importance for the chain linkages to be there, regular lubrication is to be required. That is, lubrication is at the required time to time. And these are the some diagrams I'm showing, the block chains, inverted tooth chain, roller chains are there, these lower bushings, and this is the distance between the pin, and it's called as a pitch. So these are the, just a simple example is a bicycle chain. That is a simple example of the chain. So friends, when you know the type of the belt, belt material, belt drive, you know the chain, chain drive, then you have to think that which is the most favorable one regarding the power transfer system. Think over that. We get pause for some seconds, you think over that and give me answers. Yes, so when you have to compare the belt drive and the chain drive, chain is a positive transmission system is to be there with respect to the belt, because in the belt, due to the friction, heat is produced, and due to that heat, elongation is there. Due to the elongation, length of the belt is increased, and due to which slippages is to be there. But that is not happened in the chain. Pause the video. Question is, why chains are to be used? Think over that. The answer for this one is chain drives are used to transmit a power from one end to another end to be there. Now the third type, you have to go for the gears. So gear is 100% most power transmission is to be there. And in this gear, the power transmission is because of the outer surface teeth are there. And these teeth are come in contact with each other, driver and the follower. And they are in a tapered in section because slightly come in contact, and then initially two teeth come in contact with the 20%, then goes on increasing gradually 40%, then 60%, then 80%. Because all of a sudden load is not transmitted in the gear. So that's why when you have to go for some simple example for the scooter, when you have to engage that scooter, you have to start the scooter and it is to be moved on, you have to go for the first gear, then go for a second gear, then go for the third gear, and due to that rotational, the what you call rotational mechanical energy to be increased. If you go for a directly transmit first gear to the fourth gear, you get a jerk because the teeth are not matched with each other. So that's why the motion is transmitted in the gear, that is due to slightly come in contact, then gradually goes on increasing and the motion is to be transmitted. So gear is also a positive drive. Chain also is a positive drive. When you have to compare the belt, ropes, chains and gears, gear is a 100% motion transmit system is to be there. And these are the some different type of the gears are there. Spur gears, helical gears, these are double helical gears are there, bevel gears are there. And in the gear, the spur gear, the teeth are parallel to the shaft. This is called the simple gear is to be there. Sometimes the outermost teeth are not parallel. Here it is a parallel. Here in this case, in the it called as the helical gear. They are making helix angle. It is a double helical angles are to be there. Here in the spur gear, helical gear, double helical gear, the driver shaft and the driven shafts. The driver shaft and the driven shafts, they are on the same plane. That is horizontal to the horizontal and rotary to the rotary. Here horizontal to horizontal, rotary to rotary. But sometimes you have to require the motion from horizontal to the vertical one or vertical to the horizontal one. At that we go for a bevel gears. Here the motion is rotary to the rotary, but the input shaft horizontal and output shaft is a vertical one. This is another type. And the another type is to be there. Sometimes you have to require rotary motion to the reciprocating motion is to be there. So we at that go for a racket and pinion arrangements are to be there. So these are the different type of the gears are there. In the gears also there are gear trains are there. Simple gear train and the compound gear train. In the simple gear train only one gear is attached on each shaft, that is the driver shafts and the follower shafts, and only one motion is to be transmitted. We need to go for a compound gear drive. Here more than one motion you get it from a single input shafts. Means what? In the single input shafts only one gear is attached, but in the output shaft, driver shafts, more than one gears are attached. So more than one motion you have to get it. That is another type of gear drive, that is a compound gear drive. Okay, now you think that when you have to compare the chain drive, chain motion transmission is there and gear motion transmission is there, which is more positive transmission? Think over that. Yes, comparing to the chain drive, gear drive is a more positive transmission systems are to be there. Here in the belt drive, two types are there, open belt drive and the cross belt drive. In the open belt drive, motion is transmitted from rotary to the rotary on the same motion. But in the cross belt drive, motion is transmitted from rotary to the clockwise to the anti-clockwise directions. So both are moving in a different directions. In the chain drive, comparing with the belt drive, positive transmission is to be there. When you have to go for a belt drive, there are slippages are there. Due to the slippages, power is get wasted. Gear is 100% motion transmission is to be there, but the initial cost is to be more. And here the gear drives are there in the outermost motion is transmitted due to the teeth, and teeth are in a tapered conditions. So these are the different type of the power transfer systems are to be there. So for these references, I'm going for this IGNO YouTube link is to be there. Okay. Thank you.